instruments.
It's a durational concert. I have to inform you about something. First of all, we cannot use that door anymore. We can use this door as an exit. We ask you to stay for the whole hour of the concert, but if you want to leave in the middle of it, you can, but you will be asked to give some feedback. Also, we are being filled, which is right now online streamed on Periscope, and it's going to be archived and projected tomorrow on this screen. So, we are trying to interpret this call over there. You can take it and read it, and your participation, your suggestions, very important to us.
Να μιλάμε μαζί.
I didn't understand what you
person that will be like a subject of research for some minutes. And all of us will be able to ask this person some questions in order to find the, let's say, the material roots of this conference. Is there a difference according to you? How
do you speak? Yes, it's a different situation for a lot of people and speak like English. Or maybe I can pose this question to you. Is it, do you think it's a difference between yourself and your normal life and in this situation?
Well, I think it's very related because if you are very self-confident, I think you have very deep confidence also with space, with the people, you can manage to, I don't know, to get well in every situation, any situation. But, of course, I don't know, it's my point of view. Maybe someone, for someone it's easier to be in contact with himself, but not with other people, like myself, for example. For someone else, it's easier to talk with somebody else, but not to go deep, you know, with himself. So I don't know. I ask you, what do you think?
Me.
There shouldn't be a reply.
Do you think it's easier to be self-confident with strangers around you, or is it easier to be self-confident with known persons, family, friends?
For me, sometimes it's easier to be more self-confident with stranger, but I'm a very empty person, so it depends on my mood, daily mood. So sometimes I wake up and I can talk also to a tree. Sometimes I'm completely, I don't know, I can't speak. So, but of course, the level of the deep that you gain talking to maybe a person that you don't know is different than the level that you gain talking to a familiar person, I don't know, a friend, somebody you are related to. For example, here, when I entered, I had the impression, oh, well, it's closed, oh, it's too small. But now that I see a lot of light entering, I feel at ease now, but not at the beginning. So I think in any situation, you have to enter in touch, to be in touch with the space, because we are in the space. We are space, indeed. So, and here, yes, that's okay. Also, when you start to talk to someone, if you are in a space that reflects yourself, I think you are more at ease than if you are in a space that, I don't know. I mean, for example, if you are claustrophobic, of course you are not at ease. Personality, so if you are a bit shyer maybe or not, but I think sometimes it's also an attitude that we create during our path. So we can not correct, because it's not something wrong, there isn't something wrong or something correct, but I think you can try to, you know, force a bit your way to behave. But it depends, you don't have to force yourself.
What is your occupation?
I'm an art historian, but at the moment, no. So now I'm good.
And where do you come from?
Italy. Rome. I'm from close to Rome. Parigi.
And why do you think we have been asked to talk about that here?
Yeah, I was wondering the same. I think, I don't know, because this project, Social Dissonance, I read that the artists were supposed to use us as instruments. So we are like guitar, piano.
Which instrument
are
you?
Exactly. We are doing a concert in this moment. And but I didn't understand if which kind of instrument, if really instrument or tools, or it's a fact of manipulating instrument in a way to manipulate the reality or the conversation. I didn't understand your goal.
And what would be your answer right now on this question?
Well, for sure, they are trying to catch the effect of our speech, of our relation in this moment. So they are manipulating in some way our body, our thoughts in this space to have an effect that maybe will be used for something else, who knows. For sure, because if it's on streaming now, yeah. So, but the main goal, I don't know which is. Maybe they have to reply.
But the fact, if you know the goal of that, or if you don't know it, that doesn't have any influence on your self-confidence in this situation. Mm-hmm. What does it do?
Maybe it's better not to know it, because I'm not influenced, so, you know, if you have some point of reference about it, you try to behave like how they would, but no, in this case, I don't know, I didn't know, I don't want to know, I hope I will know.
That's it.
Yeah.
and you trust.
Trust.
Because if you don't know what they are doing,
yeah, of course, it's a matter of trust.
Trust.
Yeah,
that they won't do anything against you with this setting.
Yeah.
So
I have a sort of faith, in this situation. That it's not normal for me, but in this situation, I feel comfortable, so it works.
awkward because nobody's saying something.
Why no one is asking anything anymore?
What do you think? Maybe you are not so self-confident.
Did you stay in Italy all your life?
I'm based in Berlin. Mm-hmm. So I've been in Berlin since 3 years.
Is this why your English is so good?
My English is not good. So I'm not self-confident, I love it. That's why I didn't mean to be a volunteer, but someone pushed me, I'm okay.
But she's giving you confidence.
Yeah, no, but
thank you.
It's difficult to accept.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Yeah, but for sure I didn't learn it in Italy.
So maybe now we can build a ladder from the start of the wall until the end, and you can put yourself in regards to how do you think if you are average on income or less than average on income. So it would be like living very poorly at the mm-hmm. corner until being millionaire at the other end. And you place yourself in this scale, where do you think your income in regards to your country's basic income puts you?
Within our country.
Yeah.
Worldwide.
Like the average is your country's basic income.
Okay.
Rich.
Yes. In regards to your income, you put yourself as here it would be as having zero income and being very poor to being a millionaire.
Oh.
And you put yourself in regards to if you're average or above or under average. So all of you, you have an income less than the basic income of your country. You all have less than the basic income of your country.
This is lower, higher.
Lower, higher. And this is the middle. This is the middle, basic income.
This is the average?
Yeah, this is the average.
So this is about the basic?
Basic income, yeah.
Okay. I have one question. It's based on our country where we come from? Or
where you live?
Where we live.
Where you live? Where you live? Country's standard.
It's a lot of people poor, and it's a few people very rich, so yes. Everyone moves over here.
So it seems that so far most of us are in the age of poverty.
Considering the fact that each country has a different basic income, mm-hmm. I would suggest that we take the feeling as a measurement.
Yes. So if I should describe my feeling to the rest of the world, I would move over here, because I think I live in a very rich country.
Yes.
But I'm not rich.
The average of rich depends on which people buy from where. That's the problem. Of Germany, of Europe, all over the world.
I can define my feeling to rich or poor. I think being rich means having so much money that I have to worry a lot about my money and not that much about my life. So, that's...
Do you think all rich do worry about their money?
Yeah.
That's rich.
That's my definition of rich.
Yeah, now I know it.
I think worrying about my life because I don't have money is one kind of being poor. And
they
worrying about my money more than about my life is...
They think
quite
more
rich.
Than we. Yeah, do they?
I don't know. I was asked for my definition. I don't know yours.
So possible a bit louder?
If they are only asking us for money or for like financial things, or is it also that education counts or that, I don't know, art counts or whatever it is? Because I think there's not only one form of things that you can possess and have for yourself, it's also a lot around you that can make you rich and poor.
Well, if you think about it, for example, my parents had a very good education because their parents could provide them this education by paying the money for them to study in England, for example. So in that case, this, I think it's very much connected. And this is why I put myself in this place.
Because it's not only the one moment in time right now, because it's also the perspective that you have, maybe. That because of the relative wealth that you have more connections towards other ends, right?
We're trying to understand. Once we saw that we all have the same amount of income, more or less, we are kind of average, and we speak, all of us, English, and we have the same kind of confidence. No one really stood up to say like that I'm very confident, like something like that. Why don't we have distributed voices in this space? We're trying to figure out, because most of the times we have like four people that they drive this concert, and other people that they stay at the outside circle and they don't participate. So in our trial to understand why this happens, we thought that maybe we could analyze confidence, and confidence had some material dimension that we can define, like. But it seems more difficult than that, I think.
Did you do the concept before?
Yes, a lot of times. 100 times in Greece and other 57 here.
What were your finding? Or one special finding? Have you had a specific finding until now that you could give us?
We have noticed some typical reactions to silence, for example, or to people trying to be social in this space. And this week we said to study the confidence. And
so you're not asking the same questions every time?
No.
Depending on the audience.
Mm-hmm. Depending on the day, yeah.
What kind of questions did you ask before?
Ah, a lot. All the documentation of this project is online, so you can you can follow it.
¿Estarías allí igualmente?
Okay.
estoy trabajando, pero lo que gano es el gasto.
Okay.
A fin de mes me queda.
Okay, so he basically is saying that he put himself or now that he knows what you are asking for, he's well located there because he's working with a poor salary, and all what he is earning he's spending at the end of the month. So basically he considers himself to be well placed there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
¿y dónde vives? Aquí en
Castle. Sí. Ah. Pero bueno, no estoy aquí actualmente. Ah. Estoy aquí por temporal.
La señora quería saber de dónde eres.
Yo soy de África, de Mali.
Mali. Estamos con Mali.
Mali.
¿Te gusta la documenta? He basically like to know things about the places where he is.
Mm-hmm. You are an artist? Visitor?
No, me gustaría aprender. Hasta que he comprado un libro, pero no sé cómo lo voy a aprender. Es difícil. Si alguien no te enseña y permiso lo hace. Lo voy a aprender.
No está hecho para la sala.
Pero tengo que aprender, ¿eh?
¿Y cómo es que
hablas francés?
Sí.
Francés y un poco alemán y español.
Español de habla.
¿Qué tú has vivido en España?
¿Dónde vivo yo en España?
Sí.
Vivo en México.
¿En Lima?
It's okay.
You were too in.
I change into his position and go on without understanding.
Ich habe gesagt, ich gehe in deine Position. Wenn ihr auf Spanisch weiter sprecht, dann bin ich raus. Vorher warst du raus in Englisch und dann Jesus war.
So basically,
climbing up.
You don't ask the same questions to all the audiences, right? Is this what you said before?
Yes, but I would suggest that we try to pay attention to what is happening now instead of trying to define what happened in the previous performances. Mm-hmm. So, for example, this person said that he doesn't speak English, and this by itself, I think, is forbidding him from having the confidence to speak in front of other people here.
But is that about confidence?
Sorry?
Because even before you said that
we might feel more affluent than average because all of us speak English, you said, and then you didn't say that.
No, I didn't.
But
hear
you
that.
Say that.
I said that.
Yeah, you said that.
But we don't speak all English. It
no,
seems
no,
that we don't speak. Yeah.
So is it a matter of his? What's your name?
Conan.
Is it a matter of Conan's self-confidence, or is it because of your prejudice that you think that everybody speaks English?
I thought once they stayed here, they could participate, but it's not true. Yeah.
No.
Yeah, but this is not true. This is clearly affecting confidence of the people, no?
Yeah, language is affecting.
Definitely.
Language is, affects, I mean, if you cannot express yourself in a specific language, most probably the average individual lose confidence.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Si no te puedes expresar en el idioma que habla la gente, pierdes confianza en ti mismo.
Claro, pues, a mí mismo.
Do we have other people also that they don't understand?
It's very bad, and I thought I should be able to understand and speak English, but I have hearing problems, and this room is very bad for at least for people with hearing problems as me.
For everyone,
don't
you? It's bad for everyone.
Yeah. But even if you have already still children, it's even more.
Yeah.
This room is not made for talks.
Mm-hmm. No. Not like that.
Thinking about what we just said, in my opinion, so because, for example, I come from Italy and I've been living in Germany since like 4 years, but I still struggle a lot with
German.
How
are you
German?
Where is the border between confidence and having no confidence? So, and then finally there was the word trust. And then there was silence for a long time. So it seemed to me like trust was the answer to what was your first question. So this is, and then I felt like this situation of silence became like, how do you say, sorry, can you do it aloud for everyone? Because
maybe
they're
interested also to hear your.
But my grandma is waiting.
Okay.
Because
one moment. Sorry. Sorry to interrupt. This person wants to go, so she wants to leave some feedback.
Yes, I'm a little bit in a hurry. Sorry for interrupting you.
Mm-hmm.
I said before, I understood that we have to ask questions to find out what conditions you need to feel to be confident. So, and then there was a situation in the conversation that she said the word trust, or somebody else said the word trust, and after this word trust, there was big silence for a long period. So for me, somehow this trust was the answer, because if you trust, you have confidence, and it doesn't depend so much from self-confidence, but if you can trust the situation, so you get confidence in, even if you don't feel self-confident. So, but then there was this big silence. And after a while, this silence for me became like a little bit, I felt like a little bit in prison. Because, I don't know, I felt like the rules you said before made some closure in the situation. And then you broke it by this task to make the letter. So this is my feedback. But I like it very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
What I was telling you, just wanted to say, is that in my opinion, so being able to express and to, you know, talk, really basically talk, is a really important thing for a person that wants to develop.
To understand.
Yeah, understand. Also, for example, it's of course connected also with what he asked us. So, person that comes to Germany and doesn't speak German and needs to find a job, of course, not speaking the language is a huge
difficulty, obstacle that at the end makes you place yourself.
Any country you go to, it's necessary to speak that language. It must be German, of course, but that's very difficult. And to come to integration and become a member of the society, of course, it's very, very important. Huh? But it's a question whether the people who live there come to you and to anybody who is comes as a foreigner and helps you and tries to talk to you. That's a problem. But I think it's a very, very, a big fence to climb from one place where you can't speak the language and to that point where you can join and are a member of conversation or and living in all that.
So I think that could be, that doesn't have to be, because if you feel confidence, you can just walk on and contact people, and you don't have to bother about speaking perfect or not perfect, because you go in contact.
Yeah.
If you watch children, they are in communication all over everything without speaking the language.
Of the other.
And there are a lot of people moving around and they don't understand very much of the language, but they are in very good contact with people and they don't bother about speaking perfect. I think that's something like culture thinking, oh, I have to speak perfect. Before I don't speak perfect, I won't go and talk to people.
No, that's
but
the worst. That's that is in,
that
will not help you.
There is no verbal communication that is for me most important, that speaking properly a language.
Maybe something about socialization, so that what you learned within your culture, within the things you've experienced for yourself, that you feel confident or not to express yourself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For example, I have many friends that are German, and I always try to speak German with them. Mm-hmm. But so I don't know how much they love me. So I know that they love me a lot because, for example, I'm not funny at all in German. So I'm almost another person when I speak German. I say, okay, they must be really caring person that because they are still my friends, you know. But never. I know that there are other levels of expression.
But you must be sure that you are interested in those people who are around you.
Yeah.
And then it's not a question of language, but a question of being there, going to the other, and have contact. And contact has many, many possibilities. To have it. And of course it's not the question of speaking perfect. It's the worst and it doesn't help you at all.
But it's not only a question of being perfect. As, for example, she's a quite funny person, likes to make jokes, but in German, how is she going to make jokes? You know, she's learning the language, she can communicate, she may be able to order a meal, but it's part of her personality to be funny, and it's not possible, or to express feelings. There's so many. We're so complex as personalities, and so much gets lost if we only have the basic knowledge of a language. So you're very reduced to your vocabulary in German.
Mm-hmm. It's completely true.
But I think if you are in touch, indeed, with a person, you find a way to express also this part of you. Of course, it's more difficult, it takes time, but if you're really in contact with another person, you find a way to express yourself properly, I guess. No, I think, not for sure. No, really, because
it's not only learning by doing, but contacting by doing, and all these things, it's only by doing. You must dare to do. And then it's, of course, easier, but I think it depends on the personality of each people. And some have it, for some it's much easier than for others to go to the other.
Do you think the camera also plays a role in this space? like inhibits some people to participate because of this thing with the camera that we did.
That was not really a matter for me personally, but it has always been kind of easier for me to talk to people that I know. So being in a group of strangers is a bit harder for myself.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. I just want to say we're so used to these things all over our...
Of course, if it would be another kind of, you know, technological thing would be affecting, I think, more because of what she said, because we are all used of our cell phone, people taking pictures, making videos all the time, so it doesn't really affect that much. Yeah.
May I ask you, Martin?
Please.
Why are you so serious?
Yeah.
I'm not serious.
Kind of. Can you tell everyone?
I don't know.
Yes.
Very,
very serious. No, no, because it's a serious moment. I understand we are having jokes. We are having fun, but I understand it's also work for you, so I expect it's a performance, but very serious. No, no, I don't want to be impartial, you don't want to have any...
We try to not take distance, distance. Yeah.
So you try to stay out of the group?
No, we try to be inside the group, but not to be very central or don't be the center of attention.
An empathic way. So.
That's a problem after doing it a lot of time, I think. But yeah.
I guess we have a certain kind of power in this space.
Yeah.
So, for example, if someone says something and we laugh or we smile, it's like we approve. Or if we don't, then it's like we disapprove.
Yeah, but I have this impression since when I entered, and I confess, I didn't feel very comfortable about it. But then I figure out that it was for this.
I think the silences at least are important for me because they give time and space to other people also to engage.
They are too long, you may, I don't know, if somebody is already shy, like, won't start to talk in the middle of a silent moment.
But we came together.
I think that's...
I think this is also a cultural issue because, for example, when I moved to Germany, I noticed that sometimes when I find myself within a group of people that I know, like friends, there are moments in which there is also silence. And for example, in Italy, if you are with other people and there is silence, it means okay. Something is wrong.
It depends on the, depends on the relation. If you have a very good,
In a group of friends, I don't know, entertaining themselves, then there is silence.
It's hard. Maybe German.
No, but it's. I learned it. I like it. It's also. It's very nice. It's very okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Moment of silence. They're very okay. Used to it in our culture that much.
We don't but I think that's if you are able to to manage this moment of silence and you are not uncomfortable. that you are very, very well connected with the person or with the group you are in. I think it's very important to also the silence.
So we are all well connected.
I found it very difficult today to address the subject of confidence. I think it was that moment that someone mentioned the score and the word trust. I think at that moment it was as if something was revealed and I felt that trust was kind of broken at that particular moment. I mean, it's my personal interpretation. But generally, what I think we would have liked to achieve with that the ladder, to position yourself where you feel to be the most, could be useful in order to discuss if confidence has a relation to your economical situation and how this is happening in different societies. And I found it very difficult to stick to that subject because we were very distracted. But at the same time, I found very interesting the fact that we had some people that did not speak English at all, and this was an opportunity to realize that. And I also would like to mention that probably we are 5 or 6 people who are talking most of the time, and there are many people who haven't talked at all. And I would have liked to address this matter and ask these people why do they feel like not expressing themselves. Because I think this is what we have been trying to figure out.
I would be very curious to see if we could do something at the end, because it has never happened, and they have this question, why it doesn't happen, that people say the actual income that they have, the numbers. And I would find it interesting to share the specific number of our income. I don't know if you mind, but we could pass one by one and say how much we make per month. Would you mind? I think it would be very interesting.
I'm German.
I'm German.
Yeah.
You don't, why? Is it taboo? Is this a taboo that I'm breaking without even knowing why?
Yeah, in Germany. Why? In Germany, you don't do that.
In Germany, it's like the wealthier you are, like an academic status, that you're not talking about your money that you're getting.
It's forbidden. It's a part of a contract.
It's a meta rule. Yeah, it's something that's not.
You are not allowed. I think it's ridiculous, but it is like it is.
Could we try to overcome this meta rule?
I think
in
these
we
are.
We always say how much we earn.
These are different.
In English, we always say how much we earn, but it's like the other way around. I'm getting only, you know, like 700 per month, and I can't.
But are you going to ask us money based on our salary?
Yeah, your salary. How much? What's your income?
Please keep.
Yeah, my question was, what is average? No? What is average? That would be the first.
So I think you have different situations. The one I think she was just talking about is if you work in a company, you are not allowed to talk to your colleagues about what you earn because the chief wants to tell everybody, you're my best man, you got the most money. Okay. And when people begin talking about that, they would see that's a lie. And so
they would be very astonished.
So they write it down in the contracts.
You are not allowed to talk about your income.
The company
so
writes it down in the
contract. So that is one situation, and the other is like in here, there is no boss around so we can talk about it?
We can or we cannot?
Yeah.
Yes, yes, we can. I would do. Not everybody has to do, so it's. I think it's okay.
Let's see.
But it's not German culture to do that. Yeah. So
it's not usual.
My monthly income is what I get out, not what my company pays, because I don't know that number. What I get out is about 2,500.
I get children support. I have two children, and my income plus the children support is 2,500. Same. Including the children, I don't know what you call it in English, kindergarten, it's 2,500.
Ich war bei Netto, bei Brutto weiß ich nicht, das mag ich nämlich, da steht irgendwo, das, also ich sehe ja, das kommt auf meinem Konto an, das ist für mich interessant. So.
But why?
No, we said, because people don't share this number, and I find it interesting
so
if we can...
The fact that we are sharing it, or just because you want to relate it
to where we live?
Yeah. Because later on you are going to study our face related to our...
No, there's no study like that. There's no study like that for this video.
Just the reaction.
We will think something to do with this material, but we haven't figured it out yet what we are going to do. It's open and anti-copyright, so you can also use it. And
the silent people are leaving. Somebody said the silent people should talk, and the silent people are leaving.
Maybe it's not that complicated. Maybe some of the silent people just don't think the questions are interesting, and maybe the silent people don't think it's interesting to speak about to show that I am confident enough to talk about my income. So it can be as simple as that.
Then
I tend to be tuned towards that.
Okay.
I would be interested in the number, what we think and what was thought, what is the average, no? Where do we find the average, beneath or above? What do we think, or what is the average, or what is thought is average, whether we go there or there?
Yeah, the average also depends on the